Okay, sorry I couldn't be with you live today. They're doing some work on the roof of my building and they need to access it through my apartment. So I got up early this morning and recorded this video for you. You're all working on your Macbeth essays in the coming days, and one of the hardest parts about writing an essay is getting organized. So you're going to use this sheet to organize the information that's going to go into your essay. And remember that in this case, where I write example, these are the moments in the play that support your thesis, and they should have two quotations to support them. And when you add quotations to this planning sheet, include the page number of your quotation, as well as who said the quote and the meaning of the quote. So if you look, your introduction plan should start with a hook. Now, I like to start with a quotation from the play that you don't necessarily need to peel or explain in a big way, but that will get people to want to read your essay. And we'll look at that in a moment. Next is your thesis. So your thesis is going to be the statement of what you're going to prove. Now, your thesis needs to be both big enough to allow you to use different evidence, but also small enough that you can actually prove it. So you can't say something like, the supernatural is present in Macbeth. Yeah, everybody knows that, and you can prove that with one sentence. You also don't want to say things like, the importance of the supernatural is proved by Banquo's ghost seen at the bank. Now you're getting too specific. So you need something in between the two, and we'll look at that in a moment. Then here for the examples, you're going to pick out the three scenes or the three moments that you're going to use as evidence. Then each one of these examples becomes the topic of a body paragraph. So example one becomes topic one in body paragraph one, example two, etc. Here you're going to put the quotations that you're going to use in your essay, and then jot down a couple of notes about the meaning. And finally, your conclusion is where you rephrase your thesis and then just kind of copy and paste the three examples. Because remember, our goal when writing a paper, and this is not a research paper per se, because you only have to use the one primary source, but our goal in a paper is to say what we're going to prove it, and then say what we proved. One more time, it's to say what we're going to prove it, and then say what we proved. Okay, so I'm going to flip from this empty version, which is what you're going to receive, to a semi-filled-in version so that I can show you what I expect you to do with this sheet. So highlighted in green is everything that I've added. So for a hook, go back into the text and find something that has to do with what you're talking about. Now, since I picked the supernatural here, my hook is the instruments of darkness tell us truths. And this idea that the instruments of darkness are the supernatural Macbeth, and they tell us truths, as in they tell us what's going to happen. Now, here's my thesis. Every key event in the play Macbeth is somehow caused by the supernatural. Now, all I have to do to prove that is to show key events and how they were caused by the supernatural. And I chose three examples. My three examples, which I think are powerful, are the first encounter with the witches, the floating dagger, and finally Banquo's ghost. Now, if you notice, I take those three examples in my planning sheet and I make each one the topic of a different paragraph. So, paragraph one is the first encounter with the witches, paragraph two is the floating dagger, paragraph three is Banquo's ghost, and then in the conclusion, I restate my thesis. The events of Macbeth take place as a result of the supernatural, and then restate my examples. Okay, that's the planning part. Now, the actual work here for the organization for finding the quotes, this is what this sheet is meant to help you with. Once you know what your thesis is, once you know what three examples you're using, and once you know the order, now it's just a matter of going back into the play Macbeth, whether it's the comic version or the no fear version that you're using, and find the quotes that support the points that you're trying to make. And these will eventually become your peel quotes. So here are two that I found. All hail Macbeth, hail to thee, Thane of Glamis. All hail Macbeth, hail to thee, Thane of Cawdor. All hail Macbeth, that shall be king hereafter. I put the page number. I don't need to indicate who said it because it's labeled here. And in my meaning, this is what's going to be used later for my peal. If it were not for this prediction by the witches, Macbeth would never have thought to be king. He was happy with his glory, and he even doubted the witches until he found out that he would be the Thane of Cawdor. Because of the last part of their prediction, Macbeth desires to be king, and therefore eventually kills Duncan. So what I've done is use this quote to prove that the major event, which is the murder of Duncan, took place because of something supernatural. Next, I found the quote of, "Thou shalt get kings, though thou shalt be none, so all hail Macbeth and Banquo." And again, this proves that a major event happened because of the supernatural, in that once Macbeth has killed Duncan and becomes king, he remembers this prediction, and he's angry. He laments the fact that the crown will not stay in his family, but rather pass to the family of Banquo. It's because of these feelings, rooted in this supernatural prediction, that Macbeth sends the murderers to find and kill Banquo and Fleance. So, as you can see, I found very easily found two quotations that can support this piece of evidence, which is the supernatural encounter with the witches. And this piece of evidence supports my more general thesis that every key event in Macbeth is somehow caused by the supernatural. So what your job to do this week and in preparation for your essay is to use this organizational sheet to plan for your essay. Now, I'm not going to collect this sheet from you, but I am happy to have you send this sheet to me in advance to check to see before you start writing your essay whether you're on the right track. And honestly, if you look, once you have this quotation plus the meaning, page numbers and all that, the writing of the essay is just sitting down and typing, basically. So I made this sheet to try to make your job easier. It's writing an essay can be difficult, can be tricky. And so I think that my job as a teacher is to try to make it as simplified and easy for you as possible. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email on Outlook, or if not, give this a try and then send this to me on Outlook and I can check it over for you. All right. Have a great day, and all hail Macbeth.